What's up, everybody? This is Like It's 1985, and this is my review of Transformers Generations Fall of Cybertron Deluxe Class Starscream. Let's first take a look at the packaging. And here it is, featuring some very nice artwork. You can see Starscream there. And in the back, of course, you have a look at the bio for Starscream, robot and vehicle mode, and the statistics for Starscream. So, moving on to the figure itself, let's start off by a size comparison. I'll bring in the Classics Seeker mold and compare it to Starscream here. And there you go. So quite a bit smaller. And as we take a look, close look at the Starscream figure here in jet mode, you can see the design, especially with the triangle-shaped design here at the top, is really reminiscent of the Transformers Cybertron Starscream. And you can see he's got these two weapons here, which do come off. Let me go ahead and talk about those. And you can see they do have movement, which is pretty cool. And you can actually peg them together. Like this, and they actually will move in tandem. And you can see there's a peg hole there. You could probably put another weapon there on the top of this weapon if you wanted to. Nice silver paint, pretty cool. So looking at Starscream here, pretty nice. Obviously, legs are here, arms, there's the head, and so forth. So let's get right on into transformation for Starscream. First thing you want to do when you're starting with, obviously, with jet mode, is you want to take the legs, and they actually will peg in right there and there, like that. So in this case, obviously, when I unpeg them, fold that out. Take care of the arms. You can see the arms are here, and this is the way you want the arms to look as you're transforming them back into the jet mode. So take these out. They're actually tabbed together right there, as you can see, tabbed together. Take these out to the side, like so. I come down here and bring out the toe. And you want to take the nose here and fold that in, and that should tab into place there. And you can see how there's a hinge right there, or a joint right there, there and there. You basically want to bend back this section here, pop out the head, rotate it around, and you want to have this section right here, rotate that up 90 degrees like that, and then there is a tab here and a slot there. That's going to go in place like that, and these bits will fold back like that. And just take care of the arms now and hands. And as you can see, that was a pretty simple transformation, especially into robot mode here. Really cool light piping as we focus here. So light piping at the eyes. Nice sculpt. I don't know if that's really a Starscream look, but nice sculpt nonetheless. And looking at the back here, interestingly enough, these Decepticon symbols, they're purple, but they're more of a fuchsia, or a mix of pink and purple. So that's kind of interesting. Articulation. Oh, of course, the head is actually on a swivel joint. There's no ball joint there. Shoulders on a ball joint. No, actually, no, they're not on a ball joint. They're just kind of a swivel, actually, as well. Swivel at the bicep. You have a double bend at the elbow, like so, and rotation at the wrist. There is no waist articulation. Forward on the legs, back, out to the side, swivel at the thigh, bend at the knee, and that is your articulation for Fall of Cybertron Deluxe Class Starscream. Size comparisons. Well, let me bring in the Classics mode here. I got thrust here in robot mode. I'll zoom out there. You can see there they pretty well sized, I think. He looks a bit bulkier, but let me make sure his legs are all the way out. Yeah. He actually is about the same height in terms of face to face. You know, his head meets the head of Thrust there as far as the top of his brow. So there you go. Just a size comparison there. Weapon. Well, as you can see now, it's joined together. You can actually place it in the hands for double wielding action. Come on, don't make a liar out of me. Like something like this, as you can see. I don't really like that. I like to separate them out and put them on the side of the arms for the null ray type of effect. If you wanted to, you can place them in the peg into the hole in the hand. I don't really like that look. There's a hole or a peg hole here, as you can see. So I think the best way to do this is something like this. It's not exactly on the side of the arm like with the classic Seeker or the side of the shoulder, but still you kind of get the idea of, I think, of a null ray type of weapon. Let me see. Yeah, I really wish the peg hole would have been on the side of the arm so you can have it actually coming out like that as opposed to underneath the forearm. So there you go. And I don't think you can actually peg these into the wings because there's not enough clearance, I don't think, for the shoulder. Yeah. I don't know why you want to do that, but there you go. Like I said, pretty simple transformation. And the only thing I wish is that they could use more of, instead of like blue plastic, I would have preferred like a metallic blue paint. Same thing for the red. Some metallic red would have been nice in certain places. But overall, not a bad Starscream. Let me go ahead and grab War for Cybertron Megatron and Soundwave. Also for another comparison there. That's probably what most people want to see, is that comparison. And let me sort of level out the camera a little bit and close up. So Starscream definitely is shorter than both of the figures from the War for Cybertron line. But yeah, he really should be taller, I have to say. I have to admit, I mean, granted, Starscream most of the time is depicted a little bit smaller than Megatron, but just looks a tad little bit smaller in terms of height and just overall bulk. I think it should be bigger in relation to Megatron especially. All right, well, there you go. Transformers Generations Fall of Cybertron Starscream. This is my next to last review. Next up will be the Insecticon Kickback. All right, guys. Thanks for watching.